Welcome back. We are in part 5. So in this section we are going to discuss about executing TestNG scripts into the container. Okay, so using TestNG with Selenium, I'm going to execute in a container. So what are the things you need? As you know, let me repeat it something. How to start the Docker, just go here and search for your Docker and click it, double click it, it will start, and in the panel you can see the Docker is running. Then you have to start running all the hubs and nodes. So there's a simple command as we are using right now, docker compose.yml, okay, which contain all the configurations for like hub and then Chrome and Firefox. So two session of Chrome and four session of Firefox. I'm doing it in the previous section. I have explained how to do it all, and then start it. This is a command to start all, like docker compose up minus d and then docker compose restart. This for starting and this for starting and this for down. If you want to make it down, you can make it down. Okay, so if you want to see what other things are running, I can see it. So four hub and two browsers are running here. You can see it, Firefox and then debug. Okay, these three are basically right now running. Okay, and then if you go to the code wise, what are the changes are there? Code wise changes is only like if you want to execute in a remote, you have to initialize remote web driver and you have to pass the hub URL. So hub is this URL you have to pass. So console, you can see it, four Firefox browsers and two Chrome. Okay, and you have to pass the URL of the hub. Okay, fine. Even for the Firefox also I have passed the URL. Okay, I have given multiple options, like it can run in a local, it can run in a remote, it can run in a headless also. So when the moment I pass a parameter called remote, it will execute in a container. Okay, so let me run in my local first, how the executions are happening. So I have how many test cases I have? Basically in this, two test cases are there, one and two, and this also I have two test cases. Okay, in the base class, which I'm extending in all of the classes, I'm initializing my browsers based on the command. Okay, and it will open and close the browser after every method. You can see it. So your test case should be always independent of driver initialization and it should not be dependent on other test cases. Then only you can execute in a parallel. Okay, so what I'm doing, to Chrome and to this. So let me execute in my local and see how the executions are happening. So I'll just execute it from the testng.xml and run it as a testng. So you see it has opened the browsers. Okay, so it will start it executing parallelly. Here also it has started in Firefox, also started here, also it has started. So I'm doing parallel test basically. So test means it will test, the test cases will be executed in parallel. You can start with the class, so one class will be done parallel. You can do with the method, one method will be in parallel, like from that class. So you have to understand like that. So I've given class means from this class, where is that, from this test my two test cases will be in parallel and these two test cases will be in parallel. If I give method here, it will be methods will be parallel. Okay, so it's up to you how you want to do execution in parallel. Okay, so execution happen, how much time and all take. Okay, four passed. Okay, around some 1 minute is took. Let me execute in a container now. So I'll go and just put maven command. Yeah, so you say maven clean install and minus d remote s I'm passing. So I'll just put it, so it should execute, and when it start executing, my browsers will be grayed out. So it means it has started, still not hit the hub. You see locally nothing is opening. If you want to see the test cases, how the test cases are executing, you can just log into this server, means this machine basically, and see it. Okay, so let me refresh it. Yeah, it's picked up 1-1. So 2 it will be getting executed because one at a time is happening, one in Chrome and one in Firefox. Okay, Firefox and Chrome. Okay, one execution happens, so it is cleaned up. Now this is already executing. See, executing. If I do, hopefully it execution has finished. You see, more faster than my local. I can put it as a method also. So it will take four methods. If I give methods and execute it. Okay, now still it's executing. So let me go here and see. Yes, still it is executing. So one browser, 2, 3, 4, you can see it. Four browser has got initialized and done. Four has passed. Now if you want to do it with a method, you see four will be launched at a time. So if I refresh this page, you see all are clean, all are free now to execute. You can see it. Now I'll refresh it. Let me see. Okay, some problem happened. What was the problem? Some failure is happening. I don't know. Okay, look like I have given methods. That's the reason. And M should be small. Methods. Let me put it again. Compiling. Compilation done. Now let me go here and see. Yeah, two, you see, two at a time. So means two test cases are running at a time in two of the browsers, and here two will be in the Firefox. So it's up to you how you are designing your test cases and how you want to execute it. Now one has got executed, so one has got free. And you see, it's saying executing. This is also saying executing. Executed. Okay, so if I refresh it, it's free. Let's see, is execution completed? Yes. So this is how we can execute into the our container using TestNG. There is nothing, just simple configurations. In last video I have showed you in part 2 or 3, like Docker Composer file, how to create a Docker Composer file. If I want to ramp up, suppose I want to ramp up to 20 browsers basically, or 10 browsers. Simply I'll just take this command and put it. Now my more browsers will be available. And if I want to execute more test cases, I can execute more test cases. It's coming up. Yeah, starting. You can see it. So if I want to execute more test cases, I can execute more test cases. You see, so many browsers I have. Now what I have to do, simply I'll go to the home page, I'll copy paste the same test cases again and again, 3 more times, and put it here, and change the name of the class to 44 or 55, and then I will just go here and run the command. Now this one. Now all will, now 6 test cases will be there. You can see it. Now how many are there? You see, so many test cases will start execution. Now 4 Chrome will be engaged and 2 Firefox will be engaged when my execution will start. So let's see, refresh. One, two, 3, and somewhere 4 will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 here. You can see it. So these 4 are engaged. Okay. So this is how we execute. It's executing. Okay. Thank you for watching my videos. Please do subscribe. Let's wait for execution. Then we'll close the session. And if I refresh it, you see 1. Now 2, 3, 1 has got released because the execution has completed. So you can see it, all are executing parallelly. So if you have 100 test cases, you can create 100 like that browsers and containers, like 50 containers with two browsers like that, or four browsers. You can do it. Thank you for watching my video. Please do subscribe.